Well, good morning, guys, and welcome to my YouTube channel and welcome to my flat here in Birmingham. I'm getting ready today because I'm off to watch the Mighty Sky Blues playing Sunderland up at the Stadium of Light. And I'll be taking some shots of the ground up at the Stadium of Light, and I'll be staying for a couple of nights in a couple of different hotels. So we'll be doing a review of those hotels when I arrive up in Sunderland later on today. Anyway, guys, I'll speak to you all soon, and have a great day. Bye bye. Well, here we are on the M1, guys, on our way up to Sunderland. We'll be there within the next few minutes on this video, but I'm still about 2.5 hours away with driving, but only be a few minutes on this video. Hello, it's me. How are you doing? Yes, I'm fine. Shouldn't really be doing what I'm doing just now, so I'm gonna go off at the moment, and I'll see you when we get to Sunderland. Bye, guys. Well, hello there, guys, and welcome to my YouTube channel, and welcome to Sunderland Football Club. We've actually made it. A few minutes ago we were on the video, we were on the motorway, and now we're here at the Stadium of Light, which is just behind us here. I'm going to be staying in the Sunderland tonight. It's like a house with four bedrooms in it, so I'm going to be staying there tonight, and tomorrow I'll be going to another hotel, which is going to be in Newcastle, and then I'll be making my way up to Edinburgh after that. So this is my first time here at the Stadium of Light, and to see the game Sunderland versus Coventry City. So let's see what the game is going to be today, and let's see how the Sky Blues are going to get on against Sunderland. It's the Stadium of Light, as I say. I think I'm in the home supporters area, so I'm going to make my way around to the away supporters and then take it from there. So anyway, guys, I'll speak to you soon, and I'll show you when we get inside the ground. Okay. So here we are, we're making our way around to the away supporters end. I believe it's around the other side of the ground, so we're gonna make now. And then I'll be able to put my Coventry City top on, but at the moment I don't really want to put it on because I'm in the away end at the moment with a lot of home supporters here. So I'll wait till I get around to the away supporters before I put my Sky Blue top on. Anyway, guys, I'll speak to you when we get around there. Well, hello there, guys, and welcome to the Stadium of Light. I'm now inside the ground, and I was a little bit mixed up with my seat, so I'm going to see if she can get me changed to another seat. But this side of the ground, this is the Stadium of Light. The first time I've ever been here, so it looks quite a nice stadium altogether. So anyway, the lady's coming to let me know, so I'll speak to you in a minute. Right, so anyway, guys, I've been given my seat. I'm seat 62 in row 10, right behind the goal here. I might have to get up and down to let people in and out. This is where we are today, at the Stadium of Light. And I'll just view his light from my seat. So it's not too bad, it's a good view, but it is quite high up. But hey ho, who cares, at least I'm here now, so and I'm out of the rain. Okay then, guys, I'll speak to you soon when we go to check out the accommodation later on, and if there's any goals or any penalties, I'll try and shoot them for you. Okay then, guys, I'll speak to you soon, take care, bye.
City. Good afternoon to the Sunderland supporters. And welcome to the business from Coventry. Let's take a look at our lads in red and white lined up this afternoon. In goal, number 21. The referee's whistle.
The worst Coventry game I've ever watched in my entire life. I don't think the players really want to play today because of the sacking of Mark Robbins on Thursday. Coventry playing absolutely terribly. It's like 2-0 and it's 53 minutes gone and Coventry haven't even had a shot on goal yet. So I think I'm going to be making my way out of the ground and go back to the accommodation and just give it up for today. As you can see on the board over there, it's 2-0 to Sunderland. I think I'm just going to make my way back to the hotel and just call it quits because it's just awful, awful, awful game. Okay then, I'll speak to you soon when I get back to the property. Bye for now.
Well then guys, hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. I've just got back from the football and this is the property that I'm going to be staying in tonight for one night only. It's like a house share. There's four bedrooms in here all together in this property. It's number 9 Belvedere Road here in Sunderland. So I'm going to be staying here for one night and then tomorrow I'll be moving on to another hotel in Newcastle. Just that you're actually on a main road here in Sunderland, and across the road there is the car that I came up to Sunderland in today, which I'll be taking to Scotland on Monday, and then down here is just the other end of the road. So later on today I'm going to be making my way to go and try and find a fish and chip shop or some sort of takeaway. If not the beats or Deliveroo or something like that, and and order a meal that way. So anyway, I'm going to take you inside and I'm going to let you see the... It's like a house I've got to myself, basically. I believe there is three other people here spending the night here, but I haven't seen any of them yet. As for the football, by the way, I left when it was 2-1 to Sunderland. The game actually finished 2-2, so Coventry did play a little bit better after I left the match. But I was kind of glad I did leave because I don't really like being in with all the crowd. They were a bit boisterous. I normally do hospitality. So I decided to leave early and come back home, and I'm now going to show you inside the building. So here we go. When you come up to the front door here, you've got the normal front door. You have to go into this box thing here and type in the code, but I've already opened the door already, so we'll just go in through the door just now. And as you come through the door here, just close this over. Yeah. As you come through the door here, you've got another door. And if you then come into this, in through this door, you've got the corridor. And up there, I'll show you in a minute, that room there is my room. But in the meantime, on the right hand side, as you come in through the building, you've got the living room area. So unfortunately there's no TV in my room, which I'm not very happy about, but hey ho, you know, it is just like a person's house that I'm staying in. So I suppose it's only for one night. I'll have to put up with it. Over here we have a piano, as you can see. If you're like-minded and you want to play the piano when you're staying at this property, then there's your opportunity to play the piano. Because it's coming up to Christmas, we've got a Christmas Christmas tree here. I haven't bothered to put the lights on because it's still a little way away from Christmas yet. You've got the TV here, which I've got on just to watch the football results. Then you've got your settees for, you know, just anybody can use it, I guess. Absolutely hate the curtains. The curtains are not that good at all, but, you know, it's not my house. So, you know, whatever the owner wants. Up here, we've got a nice roof and a alcove sort of thing. I have noticed that two bulbs have gone in the lighting here, but yes. So anyway, that's the living room, and now I'm going to take you through, and I'm going to show you the kitchen. Now the kitchen, it's a very long corridor. This is one of the other rooms here. I believe there's one here and three more upstairs, one of them being mine. So as you walk down the corridor here, you come into like a dining area, and it's quite dark in here, but yeah, it's like a dining area here. I have noticed that there is a fruit bowl, I suppose you can help yourself to, but unfortunately there isn't any milk in the fridge that I can see, unless definitely gone off that milk. So yep, there's no actual milk, so I'm gonna have to go to the shop next door and get some milk. So I'm just hoping that there is going to be tea bags as well, because if not, I'm screwed. But anyway, if we go through here, and we're going to have a utility room and the sink and the actual kitchen itself. So yes, let's go and see if they do have tea and coffee making facilities. Yep, there's some tea bags in there. Happy days. At least I'll be able to get a cup of tea. A little bit of sugar, that's fine. There's some coffee. Yep, great. And some digestive biscuits. Oh wow, very nice. Okay, so yeah. Got a toaster there, and the kettle, and always do a kettle check. Kettle looks, not too bad, a bit dark in there, but yeah, it seems like it's okay, that's fine.
Let's have a look in the cupboard. Oh, it's another fridge. And yes, we actually do have some milk, but I wonder if it's in date or not. It runs out on the 10th of November, which is tomorrow. So yeah, that should be okay actually. So I'll, well, at least I got some milk. Well, I'll still go to the shop and get some fresh milk. Yeah, so that's it. That's the cupboard. At least there's some tea, as I say. That's the boiler in there. You got your microwave and you've got your washing machine. So, but anyway, let's put the lights out as we go back out, and I'll take you up stairs now to show you the bedroom, or the bedroom that I've got for tonight. So anyway, go up some wooden stairs here, up to the top, and my room is the one right in front. So, as I say, I've got the key now, so we're going to make our way up the stairs again to the bedroom. And when you get to the top of the stairs, you're on your right, you've got the shared toilet and the shared bathroom with the towels to use. So, let's put those lights back out and let's go into the bedroom and have a look. So, there you go guys, we come into the room and I'll take you around and I'll show you the room just now. So guys, this is the room. It's going to be really quick because it is just a room. There's no toilet, no ensuite or anything, as I've already showed you the bathroom outside. So here I have my double bed here. You move my bags there, I've already put in. You've got a chair over there. Storage heater, a little writing desk over here. And yeah, that's it. That's all there is. And then we've got a little cupboard in here. Which is another blanket and another pillow, I believe it is, yeah, and some places where to hang your clothing on. So yeah, this is it. It's just a bog standard room within a house, and as I say, there's a door that I just came in. So yeah, that's the review of 9 Belvedere Road in Sunderland. It's nothing to write home about, nothing spectacular. As I say, I'll be looking forward to going to the actual hotel tomorrow. Anyway guys, thanks for tuning in. Look out for my video tomorrow when I'm at the hotel in Newcastle. In the meantime, as I always say, if you'd like to subscribe to a friend of mine called Yanoma Zen on YouTube. He has his own YouTube page. Most of it is songs that he's singing or miming to. He has quite a few followers at the moment, but if you'd like to follow him, then please, you know, go and find him on YouTube. His name is Tan Bin Wing. He's from Birmingham. He's a lovely person, and I'm sure that he will appreciate it if you go and look at his website and subscribe to his website and comment on some of his videos that he has on there. But in the meantime, that's the end of my review of the Belvedere, number 9 Belvedere Road here in Sunderland. And that's it really, and I'll see you all again soon. So goodbye.